In this video, we're going to take a look at the work environment. For thousands of years, our work environment was the same. We were hunting or farming outside. Our work involved a lot of physical activity. And it's only about 150 years ago that this started to change. We moved inside, first into factories, and in the last decennia, we moved into offices. Let us take a closer look at this modern working environment. Most of us now sit in offices like these. And we really sit for 8 hours a day or more. Our bodies, however, were never evolved to sit for entire days. It's been known for a long time that physical activity is healthy. And in the past, it was thought that the more exercise, the better. Olympic rowers as the most healthy people in the world. Later, however, medical research indicated that about 80% of the health gain of physical activity is already reached with moderate physical activity. Most current guidelines prescribe about 30 minutes of moderately intense activity, comparable to brisk walking for every day. In the last years, however, there's a growing body of evidence that indicates it's not only the lack of activity that causes a health risk, but long periods of inactivity, like sitting, are also associated with significant health risks. Even people that go to the gym 3 times a week have an increased risk for cardiovascular disease if they sit all day. Sitting is deadly. People have called it the new smoking. Studies indicate that the health gain from breaking up your sitting time is comparable to that of going to the gym 3 times a week. Now, there are many regulations that tell employers how workplaces should be designed. Ironically, these regulations are there to prevent people from experiencing health complaints. The truth now seems to be that these regulations guarantee you, the employee, a deadly workplace. If you put an employee on such a desk for 30 years, he will become obese, have high glucose levels, which can be considered a pre-diabetic state, and he will have an increased risk of cardiovascular disease when he retires. On the upside, if sitting is so bad for you, this also means that we can get large health benefits just from standing up. There's still a lot of discussion and uncertainty about how much you can sit before it is unhealthy. Official recommendations are scarce. In Australia, the official guidelines now recommend to interrupt your sitting as much as possible. And in the UK, an expert group came to the advice that people should stand for 2 hours of their working day and gradually increase this to 4 hours a day. In any case, the key is in changing your working positions during the day. Now, how is the office environment making us sit more than is good for us? There are no signs that tell you to sit in the office, but the environment is designed for sitting. And our bodies prefer sitting to more active positions because our bodies want to conserve energy. And that is why people sit. We sit because there are chairs. Not only office rooms are filled with chairs and desks, but also the meeting rooms. All these rooms, these environments are designed for sitting. Even the height of screens, everything is adjusted to sitting people. But there are alternatives. There are also desks at which you can work standing. And although this might seem strange to us, in the past, many people would work standing. Monks, teachers, architects, people would also stand in libraries. Children would even eat standing. And now you might wonder, well, who would be crazy to voluntarily work standing? Well, me. This is a picture of me at my standing desk, which you could easily change from sitting to standing height with the press of a small button. I've tried it for almost 2 years now, and I really like it. To tell you the truth, when I first started working standing, my legs were really tired at the end of the day. My legs were not used to carry my own weight for the entire day. They were so untrained, I was shocked. Luckily, however, within a week, I could stand entire days without feeling tired. And I also noticed how standing seemed to give me energy. For example, after lunch, I felt more awake. The after lunch dip disappeared when I worked standing up. This personal observation is also supported with scientific studies that have looked at glucose levels after meals. It's normal that after a meal, your glucose levels in your blood rise. As a result, the body produces insulin and the glucose levels drop again. Now, from people with diabetes, we know that high spikes of glucose damage your blood vessels. Therefore, it's best to have low spikes that are long-lasting, preventing the hunger feeling from low glucose levels. And that is exactly what you get when you stand after lunch. No lunch dip, long-lasting satiety. Now, you do have to alternate sitting and standing, because if you stand all day, you're at risk of developing varicose veins in your legs. Not as bad as a heart attack, but also something to avoid. There are people that take things to more extreme levels and have cycle desks or treadmill desks. If this is all a bridge too far for you, you might want to try stand-up meetings. Research shows that stand-up meetings are efficient. They last 34% shorter. And when panels blindly evaluate the decisions made, the decisions reached in stand-up meetings are as good as those reached in sit-down meetings. It's a great way of breaking up periods of sitting. Another good way to break up periods of sitting is by regularly getting up to get a glass of water, a cup of coffee, or a print from the printer. In order to keep these breaks in your routine, don't have water, printers, or coffee machines on your own desk, how convenient that might seem. Remember that your life is already too convenient to keep you healthy. Put them in a common room instead. In that way, the printer, the water cooler, they become an informal meeting place too, where you can quickly discuss and arrange things. Studies have shown that this is very beneficial for work in departments. I've called it the water cooler effect. Remember how we talked about bringing some of the nudges from the Ghanaian environment into our modern environment? If you think about it, in a way you can compare the office water cooler to the Ghanaian water pump, an informal meeting place. Another good moment to break up all days of sitting is during lunch. After an entire morning of sitting at the desk, why is the canteen again only designed for sitting? Without too much trouble, some round standing desks could be put in the canteen. Also, it's much easier to join two people at a standing table than it is to join two people at a four seats table. Standing tables in the canteen therefore also promote social interaction among colleagues and even between departments. You can also go for a lunch walk with your colleagues. That's not only a great way to get some exercise, it's also nice to reset the mind, maybe gossip about the boss a bit and blow off some steam. And truly, the food on offer in most canteens is not the most healthy choice anyway. Here too, different placement, pricing or promotion could nudge employees to have healthier lunches. Now, some might argue that it's not up to them to change the office environment, it's up to their boss. Well, even if this is true, it's also in the interest of the boss to have healthy and fit employees. And the truth is, if you ask, you could be surprised at what is possible. Of course, you can also organize things yourself. There are fold-up desks that you can place on top of your own desk to convert it to a standing desk. And whether you take a daily lunch walk is entirely up to you. The office is often looked at as a health hazard. Burnout, repetitive stress injury, chronic neck and joint problems, psychological stress. But the office environment could just as well be a source of health. Make sure that you get your daily exercise and your daily veggies in the time of the boss. Join me in the next video, where we are going to do a small experiment in your work environment. Let's see if you can nudge your colleagues to some healthier choices.